Now, straight on to the surprise. We had some subscribers reach out to us, Jeff and Kerry, long-term subscribers of the channel. They'd heard in a vlog, I must have mentioned in a vlog, that we're going to leave our bath till a little bit later to put in because it's like the last big expense and it's a little bit of a superfluous item. And Kerry heard that and she shouted to Jeff, according to the story, she shouted to Jeff, right, they need a bath, we're giving them ours. Now, Jeff and Kerry, they live in Samut Songkram, which is just south of Bangkok. It's about six, seven hours away from here. And they have given us their bath, which is amazing. And it's like a bubble whirlpool bath. They didn't use it, apparently. It was a beautiful bath. It's situated in the bathroom. And so they thought we'd get better use out of it. And he reached out to me via Instagram. He was like, you can have our bath. I'm like, wow, really? Fantastic. So we sent our driver, Montri, some of you will know him from the vlog, to pick it up from Samut Songkram.
Kun chua arai?
Peter.
Oh, Peter! Wow! Sawadee kap, Kun Peter!
Hi Ryan and Mo. Congratulations on getting your new bathtub. I hope everything goes well and the connection is no problem at all. And I'm really excited about using that space. So thank you. And hi Otis.
Otis, woohoo!
Thank you so much, Jeff and Kerry. We really, really appreciate it. And you're gonna see it in the vlog go in. We're really thankful to you for that very kind gift. So, and the kids will get great use out of it too. So I think it'll be a bit of fun for the kids. Thanks a lot, guys. Sawadee krap, chai. Mangi chamong na hap ma jak samut song khan na hap.
Khap hom, tante jet mong.
Jet mong. Praman hot jet chamong chai ma khap. แล้วก็มันหนักไหมครับ
ไม่หนักครับ
ไม่หนักเหรอ
ประมาณ3คน
3คนยกได้ Whoa, Tis! Look in there! Look at that! Isn't that cool? Yeah, 6-7 hours from Samut Songkran. What a beautiful little bath! It's gonna look perfect in there. I mean, it's hard to tell from a picture sometimes. Jeff sent us a picture through, obviously. But it's hard to tell what would it look like in there. But now I've seen it, it's absolutely perfect, isn't it? The universe conspires sometimes.
That's a cool bath, you know.
That looks cool, doesn't it, Tis? Yeah. But can we get it in the door? Dun, dun, dun! So we're about to find out if this bath fits or not in the door. So the builders seem to think that we can't get it in the door. We can only try tomorrow because the tiles are still wet. But it got in this door, we'll hopefully get it in the next. All right guys, well we vlog everything here. And this one's a doozy. If you watch this vlog, you know that I order a lot on Lazada. And I ordered a catapult for me and Tis because we throw stones into a little pond nearby. I thought I'd get my really good catapult. So I ordered this. Catapult, and just so I'm just not making this up, you can see the order number here that's come on this package that's come today. And what did we get? What turned up instead of a catapult? A bell. As soon as I picked up the package, I was like, what's that? That can't be a catapult, it's a bell. But this isn't just any old bell. A red bell that says ring for sex. Of all the most random things that could arrive, we get a bell. Babe, Tom, I'm not making this up, am I? This came today, didn't it? And with the order number is for a catapult, right?
Yeah.
And we've got a bell. Do you want to keep it or not?
No.
Well, just in case. Yeah, I mean, only in Thailand with something like this. I mean, what's that shop doing as well? They've got one line of merchandise, catapults, another line of merchandise, bells for sex. So there you go. But I am going to return it. But I'm sure if anybody wants one, I'm sure they're somewhere on Lazada. You can find them. So it's in. All right, we got it in. That's good progress. Quite worried about that, actually. Quite worried we weren't going to get that in. But we're in. I long out on ing to work my day. Cap on. Cap. Map a line,
huh?
Song Chamong, huh? คิดว่า1วันเคยซ่อมแบบนี้ไหมครับ So this guy is the fix everything guy. He's local to the village. I hit a stone with the lawnmower. Typical, right? It's a building site, so there's lots of hidden stones. But it's my fault. I was mowing a place that you shouldn't really mow. Hit the stone and it bent all of the thing around. So I said to Dan, so what are we going to do? It's a brand new lawnmower. I've really knackered it underneath. I bent all of the well, as you saw, of the blade. She said, we gotta get the fix everything guy in. Who's the fix everything guy? This is the fix everything guy. And he just said to me, oh, it's gonna be a little bit of time. I was like, well, I was thinking about a week or something. So it's gonna be about 2 hours. So to fix everything guy. Everybody needs a fix everything guy, especially when you're like me. Like, there are a lot of men out there that are very good with cars and engines and stuff like that. That ain't me. I'm learning. The more I spend on the farm, the more time I spend on the farm, I learn more, but I am just rubbish. Like her brother, brilliant electrician, brilliant mechanic. You know, when he does that, I'm just like, oh, how does he do all that? I need to develop these skills. These are good practical skills, and the skills that I want Otis to have too as he gets older. These are important things to know, you know. What were they teaching me in school in the UK? Didn't teach me how to fix an engine, didn't teach me anything about mechanics. All I got was algebra. Did I make up? Oh.
อ
ันนี้มันอังเกาทำใหม่เหรอ
คร
ับ
ผมทำใหม่
คนสเปรย์สีดำอ่ะ
ใช่ครับไปทำฟันมัน
ดีแล้วครับผมขอเข้ามาครับ
เมียบอกว่าคนซ่อมทุกอย่างได
้บางอย่างมันก็ไม่ได้
เหรอ
บางอย
่
างก็ไม่ได้เพราะว่ามันไม่สามารถซ่อมได
้ครับผม
เหมือนกับว่ามันเละมากเกินไปก็ต้องซื้อใหม่บางอย่างก
็ซ่อมได้จริงๆนะนี่ผมเพิ่งซื้อนะใช้ซ่อมครั้งแล้วมันแพงพังดอนหินแต่ว่าผมคิดว่าเครื่องมันโอเคอยู่ใช้ได้อยู่
น่าจะพังแต่ตัวไป
ใช่
ก็ม
ัน ห
ม
ุ
นอยู่
เมื่อผมดอนหินเครื่องดับ
มันฝืดเกินไปมันก็ดับ
ใช
่ Well guys I just tested it out and it was a little bitIt's come out again.
นี่ไงต้นเหตุ
It's a double whammy. I'm going to pay the guy now, the fix it everything guy. Song Royler. So he wants 200 baht for coming over and fixing the lawnmower. So I think we'll give him a little tip too. So as you can see, he's just working on the wood now. We're getting these guys to do all the woodwork, all the furniture, all the shelving, that kind of thing. We could have hired somebody in, but they said they wanted the job and they can do it. So we're happy for them to do that. All of the wood that we're using is reclaimed wood. And the stuff that he's doing now is actually going to be for the bathroom. So just behind me here, we built this little zone. We've tiled it on the side there, if you can see. And this will be for a shelf. So there'll be a nice shelf there. And I think there's only five in total, and that's the wood we're going to use that he's just shaving outside there. And he's just tiled the zone here that the bath's going to go on. So the bath will sit on that area there. And then we made it slightly lower where the shower's going to be. This is quite a thin area for the shower, so the reason I wanted to tile it up to the wall there is to define that zone. If we'd not tiled it there, I think it would look quite like small and squashed in. But I think because we have defined the zone with the tiles up the wall and doing this kind of lower area for the water at the bottom, then I think it's going to be more aesthetically pleasing and practical. So as you can see, Damo's brother's put in the extraction fan up there. We then have to have one hot water for the shower there, and we're going to have another hot water for the bath here. So what you see behind me is a perfect mix of me and Damo. Damo loves the natural woods. This is her idea here for the counter and the shelves behind. I'm into patterns, particularly geometric patterns, psychedelic patterns, and so that's why I chose this tile here at the back and at the back of the shower. So together, the bathroom is really like half my mind, half her mind, come together in this beautiful mix. This piece of wood now is in, and it's pretty solid. We've attached it in some places behind too. And this piece of wood here, another tree that we found, we've taken that one and put it there on the wall. I think that looks really nice. In this area here, we're going to be reconditioning that big round piece of wood I showed in a previous vlog and making that into a dining table. You can see the skirting board has gone on as well in the bedroom. There's the skirting board all around there. Skirting board all around this area. You're right, Tess. We also framed these doors. They've not been lacquered yet, but we will lacquer them just so the wood blends together with the wood that we've used up in the mezzanine there. Say hello. Mulberry?
Yeah.
Do you like mulberries?
Yeah, Mummy is black one,
no. Okay, then I'll have one. Thank you very much. Yummy.
Yeah, very yummy.
So, as for the upstairs floor here, you can see we've done a laminate. Just a laminate floor. It's worked out quite well.
think the colour is nice up here. We still got to lacquer that step there, and we've used a little bit of the skirting around the sides. The laminate is done up here now. Very nice. And up here's the balcony. So I think you've seen this view a few times now on the vlog, but it'll never get old. Really quite beautiful, and it is getting to the sunset time now, so we'll put some seating up here. And here's the view from up in the mezzanine. So we've decided to have some more concrete put in here, just so you're not running mud inside. A little bit of our outdoor path. So we may not tile this immediately, we may just leave it as it is for a little bit, but and get it tarred later. But yeah, we thought we'd put a path in here. So what's the update on the baby?
Coming soon, 1 more month.
What the doctor say?
Doctor say now I have to go every like 1 month, every 2 times per month to check. Yeah. And we're gonna do C-section.
C-section. So I wish I could tell you how many days it's been that we've had these turkey eggs in. I just don't know. But we have to check if they're viable. So one way to test the float test, if we put it in, if it was to sink to the bottom, it's not viable. If it floats about 40% above the top, it's not viable. If it floats just a little bit like this, which is, that's perfect, we've got a viable egg here. That one, I would say, is just passing the test. I say it's just passing the test. It's not. If it floats really high up, it's gone. It's a dud. If it sinks down to the bottom, it's gone. You need it to be floating, just bobbing along for a viable egg. So we're still good there. Let's do the last one. Yeah. So I'd say we've probably got 3 viable eggs. Although I have done a light test on one of these. And the light is very clear and opaque. Doesn't look like there's anything forming inside. So it could be that only 2 of them are still viable. What I'm doing now is I'm just keep putting them back in the incubator. I'm setting them to about 37.5 to 38 degrees. I'm just gonna leave them like that. And then one day some chicks will come out, hopefully. But I feel like we've been waiting a long time already. So that's the best I can do. I don't know any other ways to test the viability than the light test and the float test. I'm sure there are other ways, but I just don't know them. All right, so interlude here. It's the middle of the night. Lucky I got the camera at work in the night. I'm in the kitchen, just been chatting to Damo, and I can hear that sound. You know what that means, don't you? The turkeys. Turkeys have hatched. Look at these two. Unbelievable. 2 turkeys. Hello, little ones. So I don't know about this third one. Don't know what's going on. But these two, they're out, aren't they? Hi, guys. Hi, guys. Now, the trick is going to be keeping them alive because they're difficult to keep alive, these turkeys. I'm just going to put them back in the incubator. You might think, oh, why are you putting them back in there? But it's because it's warm in there. And the key things with little birds like this, and I'm no expert, but you've got to keep them warm. That's the first thing, like keep them warm. So what we're gonna have to do now is I have to get the cage that I prepared and get a light on it, and they're gonna come in with me in the bamboo hut because they don't like drafts. If the animals got to them, it'd be a disaster. It's better they come and live with me in the bamboo hut tonight. So they'll be tweeting all night, no doubt. Turkeys, guys, turkeys. I can't wait to see how, when they grow up, what they look like. These turkeys, these special turkeys, yeah. Oh, can't believe it. It's great. It just happens. It always happens when you least expect it. You're like, you're not thinking about it at all, and you hear these tweets in there. Go on, have a look.
Two of them.
Two.
Oh, you have two, these duck eggs.
No, that's a turkey egg too, but I don't think it's viable. They're quite big, aren't they, in comparison?
So what are we gonna do next?
Next stop, get the cage, get the light, the heat light, and give them some food, some water, and they're gonna come in the bamboo hut with me. So just to update you, this is the next day, and both chicks are doing really well. They stay very close to the lamp. They like it at like 100 degrees F. That's the temperature they actually like. You've got to keep them really warm. They've been very quiet. They're inside my bamboo with me because, well, I want to keep an eye on them. And I also don't want the dogs or the cats to get to them. They can be very tricky here. So overall, they're doing really well. I'm really, really happy with it. Both have survived the first night. It's the first week we have to watch. First 7 days and see how they get on. So you got to keep fresh water there for them, a little bit of food. Beautiful, aren't you? Keep nice and warm in that light. Looks like we're gonna have a brown one and a black one. So you're gonna see these turkeys get big, so long as I can care for them properly. Yeah, I think this one's gonna be a light brown and this one's gonna be black. And they're very soft and sweet, and they go to sleep as well, so they're not so noisy. And they seem very comfortable in here. I've put them in a box inside a little box, you see, so they can't wander away from the light. Because sometimes they can wander away from the light and then not find the way back. And then they get too cold, and they catch a chill and they die. So, there you are, turkeys! And so as you can see, Damo insists on working, even though she's pregnant. And we're doing the last fence at the side of the road here. So we fenced off all the back, which you would have seen in a previous vlog, and now we're fencing off the side. This is the last bit of barbed wire fence for safety that we have to put in to our area, to our land. Babe. Working when pregnant. Can't stop, can you? And this was the one we did last time. As you can see, it's becoming quite overgrown now. But it just protects the back of the house. Stops anybody climbing over. We'll probably take a hedge trimmer to this. We just haven't done it since we've been back from Bali. Just keep some safety in this area, an extra layer of safety. On the inside fence we're going to be using bamboo, but on this outside perimeter, barbed wire is what we go with, and we go with 5 rows too. So this is a big lur. What does a little lur look like? Do you know? Does smelly begin with M?
No.
What does smelly begin with? Smelly.
Here.